you've been outside, but tonight feels like you're home for life. You know you live, but I want you, so I roll that dice. She tastes so sweet like caramel, girl, your skin, it shines. You moved from Brooklyn back to Oakland, cause you know that you missed everything about this side. You can't stay away from Oakland, and you know that you missed everything about this life. Truth be told, you'd probably rather be in Oakland. I got your back for life, and you ain't never gotta ask me twice. You started dancing, quit that 9 to 5, and you've been working overtime. We used to mix ivy with the Hennessy, back when you was just a fantasy. They say what's meant to be is really meant to be. No matter what, it's always you and me. Cause you're an East Oakland warrior.
So, I'm currently headed to the airport right now. My mom came down, so somebody has to be with me for a full 24 hours after my surgery. And my mom has always been there for me for a lot of things, same as my dad. But yeah, my mom decided to come down, or come up actually, and take care of me while I am going through my recovery process after I'm done with surgery. So I went and got her some breakfast really quick because she asked if I could get her something. She just landed. I'm about to pick her up right now. And it's currently 9:58 right now. I gotta check in by 11. And surgery starts at 1. So.
So I made it here inside the medical center. So the surgery is about a 2.5 hour process, so I'm gonna be here for a little bit. But I don't think I have to stay here overnight, so or for the rest of the day. We'll see. But I shouldn't have to.
I had to come into the bathroom real quick, but they just called me back, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started and wish me luck.
This is really about to happen. Like, this is really about to happen.
How are you feeling right now?
Nervous.
What you nervous about?
I don't know, because I never had surgery. She stuck a big needle in my hand.
Let me see.
I don't even want to lift my hand up. I don't know. I can lift it. Does it hurt
don't
when you lift it?
Don't tell on me.
I don't know.
Okay, I'm
going to
wipe down your foot with a little wipe.
Layer of protection against infection. But they do way more prepping in the OR. Our plan for you, we're going to put you completely to sleep with a breathing device. We don't need to talk that much about that, okay? We're going to get you into the room, we'll give you a lot of medicine, you'll go off to sleep through the medication from the IV. We put something in your mouth to help you breathe through the procedure, and then we wake you up at the end of it. Okay?
So,
Has anybody like tried to fight the anesthesia?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
People do. And because you're a young, otherwise healthy male, you probably will need a lot more anesthesia than we anticipate.
Really?
Yeah.
What if I just like don't go to sleep?
You will. Everyone tries to fight it, but it eventually will hit. Propofol is a strong drug. All right. Well, speaking of, actually, something that'll also affect how much you need. Do you drink alcohol?
No.
Never?
No.
Okay. Smoke any tobacco or marijuana?
Mm-hmm.
Any other drug use? I know mom is right here listening to.
No, she knows I don't do that.
Okay. And it's not for me to judge. It's more so people that smoke marijuana or drink a lot of alcohol need a lot more anesthesia, so I don't want to shortchange you.
Okay, that makes sense. Because they're like high all the time.
Yeah, exactly. If your brain is always kind of in that state, you might need a little bit more.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Other than the general anesthesia, you know, I was talking about the breathing device we put in. It's a very soft, flexible device, so it shouldn't hurt anything. But you might have a little bit of a sore throat afterwards. Okay. You have very nice teeth. We're going to keep them exactly like they are, okay?
What's the breathing device?
So we do, it's standard for this kind of surgery. It's essentially just a flexible kind of...
Wait. Are you putting like a whole tube in my...
Not all the way through the trachea, no. It just sits on the tongue and keeps your tongue forward and your airway open.
Oh.
You'll be completely asleep while it's in, okay? I promise you, you won't remember that part. You may wake up with a little bit of a sore throat, though. Can't really do this procedure any other way. You know, unless we did like a needle in the back, which I'm sure you don't want that.
So back?
Yeah. To like numb your legs. Like, you know how women get epidurals pregnancy?
Oh, no.
I agree.
Did you do that? Did you have epidural? They shot you in your back area. I thought epidurals are in your butt. Like.
No, it's all the way in the back.
What? No.
So we won't do that for you, obviously. But so if we don't do something like an epidural, the only option is to do a breathing device. Yes.
Everything's going well.
Everything is great. We're just doing EKGs.
Are we ready to go back?
He's consenting right now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Post op.
Yeah.
Correct.
So it's like surgery of cooling.
Yes.
I'm not here.
Agreed.
Work quickly.
Yeah. We agree. I think he's doing the case solo.
You're okay, buddy.
Go see the second room for that. We need to tell him.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, boss. So nice to meet you. I'm Dr. Krulin's residence. Okay. I'm Dr. Rundava. We're going to take care of what side today?
Right ankle.
Exactly. What are we doing? I know and you know, but I got to hear it out loud.
Type room.
Yeah, okay, good. You even know the implant. You want to do the case too? Okay. We'll wake you up and say, hey, put in this tightrope, okay? No, exactly. We're going to do basically two type of procedure. One, we're going to do arthroscopy. So that's where we take the scope, arth meaning joint, scopy meaning scope, right? So we're going to take a little scope to look into the ankle joint itself. That'll help diagnose things well and also help get a better sense of the injury that we're treating, okay? If there's any weird-looking tissue in there, scar-type tissue, right, then we can also remove some of those things because they can cause impingement, pain, stiffness,
mm-hmm.
things that might hamper you from getting back to your sport, okay? The other thing that helps us take a look at is the cartilage. To make sure with these injuries or with wear and tear, you don't have any big cartilage lesions or damage.
Okay.
If we see something significant there, sometimes we can do basically little cartilage-stimulating procedures or even put a cartilage graft. Often, if it's that, we do that in a second procedure, where we either get it from another part of your body or from like cadaveric allograft. That's why we're not doing it in this case often. We usually just poke the cartilage, the bare spot, with a little tiny needle that stimulates bleeding and stimulates healing.
Okay.
That's primarily what we do in this first case, just if we see that.
Okay.
I don't expect that we're going to see that because we obtained an MRI. What we're going to do now is mark some of these landmarks. And you're going to help us, actually. We're going to ask you to move your toes and stuff in a second.
Bend your ankle up towards yourself. Yeah, strong and hold it there.
It's going to help with that scope part you talked about.
All right, relax a little bit. Relax a little bit. Yeah, hold it right there.
Okay.
kind of hold your toes up, all your little toes, hold them up strong. All right, relax, just really relax. Yeah, let me hold your foot down.
It's a little bit of the pregame.
What's pregame?
As in a little bit of anti-anxiety medicine.
Oh.
You go, I can do it for you.
This is what puts me to sleep or puts my anxiety down?
Puts the anxiety down. Do you still feel anxious?
You look like Toad.
She got that on video too.
I'm sorry. You didn't give me anything, did you?
I did. Oh, nice. I did.
Remember, you gotta be cool and calm and collected when you go in. And then when you get out, you'll be cool, calm, and collected when you get out.
Are you feeling cool, calm, and collected right now?
Yeah.
See? I think it took effect then. All right, bud, let's get out of here.
Jennifer?
No.
Nauseous on an empty stomach from like after I give you the oxycodone. Okay? Ready? 4852. Yes. So I have liquid oxycodone for you, okay? Open your mouth for me, dear. There's a little bit more.
It's an ass. It's
fine. I'll give you some water after. I'll give you water after, okay? Just a little bit more. There you go.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Bye.
Like a Popeye biscuit. It's dry as fuck.
You should be able to like eat when you go home, but
almost.
Your tummy might still be sleepy by then.
Huh?
You can eat when you go home, but your tummy might still be sleepy.
Why would my tummy be sleepy?
Because of the anesthesia. So our recommendation is you start off with small amounts at a time.
I'm dry as cran cracker.
Okay.
That's for now.
We know.
Just until you go home. Water? Okay.
One more piece. Open.
That surgery was kind of quick.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be, but he wasn't lying. I went to sleep and woke up and I was done.
Thank you.